CCTV America in Washington, D.C., and I anchor our two evening newscasts at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and 8 p.m., an hour-long newscast. I also host the talk show Full Frame. I had the good fortune a couple of years ago of being able to MC an event for the Chamber in Washington, D.C., and it was a fantastic event, and I'm sure that tonight's will be much the same, and I'm really looking forward to playing a part of this fantastic evening.
Thank you. Already? Hi. I'm Gary Barnett from Extel Development Company. I'm the CEO. Just wanted to say how happy I am to work with the Chinese organizations and with many people from China. We have a number of EB-5 investors that are coming into some of our projects. We have buyers who have bought from us at 157, which is, as you know, the most beautiful building in New York City. And we have our new project coming up, One Manhattan Square. And we're very happy to have a close relationship. In fact, some of our partners are in fact Chinese companies. So overall, I think it's a wonderful thing to see the relationship between Chinese business and the United States, and we're happy to continue and happy to meet all of you. Thanks.
Okay. Well, I'm very pleased to be here for the CGCC, the China General Chamber of Commerce dinner. This is actually, will be the third address I've had in front of the CGCC, which I think bespeaks the importance of this organization in our bilateral commercial relationship. And I'm very much looking forward to joining this group again, and in particular in honoring my friend Ni Pin, who will be receiving the Chinese American Businessman of the Year Award. So thank you, and I look forward to this evening's festivities.
Hello, my name is Scott Patterson. I'm Executive Director of the National Governors Association here in the United States, and I just want to say I'm absolutely delighted to be here this evening. The governors in the U.S., across the country, regardless of their party, whether they're Republican or Democratic, want to have a very good relationship with the Chinese, and part of that is to have a very good relationship between the businesses in their state as well as the Chinese, because they see trade and interaction with business both in their state and China as beneficial to them. It will develop the economy of not only their states and the United States here, but also it will assist with economic development in China as well as the rest of the world. So it's all very positive that even in the United States, when you see a very polarized political system at the moment, that all governors of both parties are very interested in interacting with the Chinese, with Chinese businesses, with the Chinese people, and trade, of course, is extremely important for them, and they have been very supportive of trade between the two nations, as well as trade throughout the Pacific and the world. So thank you very much. I'm delighted to be here at this gala.
Thank you all for having us this evening. CBRE Group is very honored to be here to be a partner of the year to the China General Chamber of Commerce. I'd like to thank Xu Zhen and everyone involved in the organization. We've been working with the group for over 20 years and have had a wonderful opportunity to form a close relationship as you begin your investments in the New York City market. And I wish you all the best of luck in the year of the monkey. And I took time to find monkeys. And this is really a fabulous organization, and we wish you great luck and a wonderful, strong future together. Thank you.
My name is Bill Shanahan from CBRE in New York. I'd like to thank the China General Chamber of Commerce for the honor of being able to attend this great event. It is really a tribute to the business that our two nations conduct together, and the success with which we do it, that we're able to host this kind of an event. Let me say Happy New Year, the Year of the Monkey, and wish you all the greatest of prosperity, luck, and health to your families. Thank you so much for inviting us.
Well, let me congratulate the China General Chamber on its annual dinner tonight. In many ways, when I think about it, in 1979, when I arrived in China, it would be impossible to think that there would be a China General Chamber in the United States. But today, here we are, and look at the number of people and the number of Chinese businesses that exist in the United States and are members of the China General Chamber. And what that is doing, what these Chinese businesses are doing, are bringing the United States and China closer together. So I congratulate the China General Chamber, and I'm sure tonight will be a great success.
Hello, my name's Gil Buitrago. I'm the manager of consolidator sales for Delta Airlines. We're glad to be here in partnership with the Commerce, Chamber of Commerce. We're here to actually encourage more business going in and out of the United States into China, so we can both prosper in this new business venture. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Kathy Wild, president of the Partnership for New York City. We are New York's business leadership organization, and we consider New York City to be the Western capital of Chinese business. We are delighted with the active investment in New York real estate, in business expansion and job creation that is taking place because of the commitment of Chinese companies to building their global business empires here in New York. And we appreciate the efforts of the Chinese American Chamber of Commerce and so many of the business leaders who are our partners in building our shared economies. Thank you.
My name is Kathy Hoke. I'm the Lieutenant Governor of the State of New York. Tonight I'm representing our great Governor Andrew Cuomo. And I'm so happy to be here at the China General Chamber of Commerce Lunar New Year celebration, Year of the Monkey. And I have been so blessed to have so much interaction with people in the Chinese community here today, as well as last year when I was running for office and celebrating so many of our important festivities like the Lunar New Year. So we are really grateful for the businesses from China who are doing business here in the state of New York. We also know we're the number one destination for Chinese visitors to the United States, and we are here just to say thank you. Thank you for investing in the state of New York. Thank you for believing in us as a great place to do business, to live, work, and play. And we are very proud that we are home to so many Chinese who have made America their second home. And I wanted to thank everyone for coming out tonight and celebrating, and Happy New Year.
中国企业在美国的立足发展和它的成功，本身就向世界证明了中美之间存在着互补互利的这样一种关系，是可以合作共赢的。如果说中美关系是一个高楼大厦，总商会所有的成员在美国的成功都是为这个大厦的建设添砖加瓦。往前看呢，我们也希望总商会和它会员企业能够再接再厉，再创辉煌，不仅自己在美国的经营要搞得更好，取得更大的成功，而且要为中美关系的发展，为中美两国人民的友谊和了解做出更多的贡献。我相信我们的总商会一定能够做到这一点。
China's investment in the United States soared from about near zero in 2000 to $48 billion at the end of 2014. China is now our fifth largest source of overseas investment.And foreign companies in the United States, including many of the Chamber's member firms, employed more than 6 million people in the United States last year. That's incredible. And I wish the Chamber a wonderful 10th anniversary and continued success in the years to come. Keep up the good work.
Opportunity for growth in the investment relationship that has not been realized yet. For the two largest economies in the world to have less than 5% investment in each other's economies, that's way too small. you know that the natural tendency is going to be a push to grow that investment. What has to happen is for investment barriers to be removed to allow that investment to increase.
We have a long history of working closely with the China General Chamber. So I congratulate the organization on this historic milestone. U.S. Chamber just celebrated 2 years ago our 100th anniversary. So I'm sure 90 years from now, this organization will have grown in stature and presence and will continue to play a very prominent role in supporting the U.S.-China economic relationship.
中国总商会 诚信 合作 共赢
大家好，我不是中国人，各位贵宾王昌豪，我是CCTV的主播Mike Walter，有朋友用风来不一留胡，我为是一点普通话，可是我说的不好。 That's as good as it gets, folks. Sorry. When I speak Mandarin, there's nothing but pained expressions because the people who don't understand Mandarin are just like, oh, I hope this guy's going to talk like this all night long. However, the people who do speak Mandarin say it even louder, oh, I hope this guy's not going to talk like this all night long. Because I do butcher the language, and I know that, so that's why I'm stopping now. But I want to welcome all of you here. For those of you who don't know, I said when I was going like this and gesticulating, I was actually saying something tremendously shocking, which is I am not Chinese. I'm often mistaken for Chinese, as you could probably imagine. And then I went on to greet everyone and tell them that I'm an anchor at CCTV America. And I have the good pleasure of being the MC tonight. It's going to be a fantastic evening. I had the opportunity to do this a couple of years ago in Washington, D.C. It's an extraordinary gala. And I got to tell you, the folks sitting back there and throughout, if you bump into them, thank them very much because the people from the chamber do a great, great job. In fact, let's give them a big round of applause right off the bat. So it's my honor and privilege to introduce the chairman of the CGCC. He is also president and CEO of Bank of China USA. Mr. Xu Chen began his banking career actually back in 1990. Among his achievements, and this was a major achievement, he was the general manager of the Olympic Affairs Department in 2004. And so that was a department set up specifically to supervise the bank's efforts of offering the best banking services for the Olympics. And the Bank of China, of course, was the sole bank partner of the 2008 Olympics in Beijing. In January of 2015, we are lucky enough to have him come over here to the United States, and he was transferred here where he supervises, get this, he's a busy man, the New York branch, the Queens branch, the Los Angeles and Chicago branches as well. So he's very, very busy. But please give a warm welcome to Xu Chen, who's going to kick off our proceedings with the opening remarks.
Thank you, Mike. I'm a Chinese. 我是中国人
Dear members and friends of CGCC, ladies and gentlemen, and honored guests, good evening, 晚上好, 大家. It is my distinct honor to welcome each and every one of you to the CGCC annual gala and the celebration of the upcoming Chinese New Year of the Monkey. We are grateful to have with us tonight the Chinese ambassador to US, Mr. Cui Tiankai, and the Undersecretary of U.S. Department of Commerce, Mr. Stephen Selig, who traveled from D.C. only to attend this special event in support of the CGCC's diligent and important work throughout the year in the U.S.-China business community. I would also like to thank Consul General of China in New York, Madam Zhang Qiyue, Lieutenant Governor of New York State, Ms. Kathy Hochul, and Congresswoman, Ms. Grace Meng, for being with us this evening. The CGCC Annual Gala is a highly anticipated event that undertakes three main tasks. First, to celebrate the expanding friendship, bonds, and cooperation in the U.S.-China community that all of us have worked so hard to build up year after year. Second, this evening also gives us opportunity to recognize and thank several outstanding individuals and organizations for their extraordinary accomplishment in the U.S.-China business arena. These people and companies have shown us that despite the volatility in the markets on both sides of the Pacific, the China-U.S. economic relationship is growing closer every day. Last, but certainly not least, it is also our annual fundraising event. As you can see from the program, we are honored this year to have so many gracious sponsors for this event. I wanted to personally thank each and every one of you and organizations you represent for not only being such dedicated members, but also for your support this evening and during the year. And it goes without saying that this charity dinner and the growth of the organization would not be possible without your guidance and generous contributions and supports. Well, I certainly cannot call out every single sponsor. Please allow me to take this opportunity to acknowledge several of them for their extraordinary support. China Construction America, related companies, SL Green, Anbang International, CBRE, Ernst & Young, Hainan Airline Group, JLL, Excel Development Company, Star Foundation, Starwood Capital Group, and the Vornado Realty Trust. We truly thank you and look forward to supporting and working with you even more in the coming year. Tonight is dedicated to the upcoming Chinese New Year. We have tried in every way to bring you as much of China and Chinese culture as possible. The plum blossom on your tables, exquisite arts and crafts, and of course, the most important, the Waldorf Astoria Hotel itself. Joining us all the way from Beijing, we are also honored to have been able to bring you the chairman of a company that now owns this luxurious, beautiful landmark, iconic hotel in the heart of New York City. Please give a warm welcome to the chairman of Anbang Insurance Corporation, Mr. Wu Xiaohui. Thank you.
Welcome everybody to the Waldorf Astoria.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
I think it's only appropriate that actually my new landlord at 717 I'm now translating for this evening.
大家今天看到这个 Waldorf 这样, 将来还会更加的漂亮。
Everybody tonight sees the beauty of the Waldorf Astoria. In the future, there are even bigger plans to make it even more beautiful.
我们会把这个 Waldorf 经过改造打造成一个纽约的活动中心。
We have plans to make the Waldorf Astoria even more the center of activities and attention here in the great New York City.
是一个未来，是一个纽约的一个非常非常辉煌，大家喜欢来的地方。
It'll be the future fancy and favorite place for New Yorkers to come entertain.
那么。 今天感谢大家来到沃尔多夫。
I'm most grateful and appreciative for everybody's attendance this evening at the Waldorf.
我相信这个在纽约的这个投资，在沃尔多夫的投资是一个很好的投资。
I'm very confident that our company's investment in the Waldorf Astoria will be a good investment.
我们会在纽约进行更多的投资，会聘请更多的人，让中国的经济和我们美国的经济大家都会受益。
Our plan is to continue our investments both in New York and the United States. Here in New York, to grow our investments, hire more employees, and really join the economies together to grow in a mutually beneficial manner.
所以我想纽约有很多很好的投资机会，中国也一样有很好的投资机会。
Just as much as New York has many opportunities to invest, I also believe China has many opportunities and very many good opportunities to invest.
我们在中国的投资好多那个分红率都在5%以上的股票，所以欢迎美国的朋友也可以到中国来投资。中国的经济还是非常的健康的。
The returns in China are actually quite good. We've done very well in our business, in our investments, over 5% and much higher.
因为大家现在都在议论中国的经济，每一个朋友都在问。
A lot of people ask about opportunities to invest in China, and certainly I do believe there are plenty of opportunities to continue there.
应该有很多很好的投资机会。
Again, many opportunities to invest.
跟美国一样。
The same as the United States, plenty of very good opportunities to invest here. We're looking very closely at.
所以大家不要放过发财的机会。谢谢大家。Thank you.
Thank you very much. Enjoy your evening.
接下来我荣幸地请我们崔天凯大使给大家发表演讲，谢谢 ，Thank you。
Allow me to introduce the ambassador for the People's Republic of China, Mr. Cui Tiankai.
Thank you, 吴总。Let me thank Chairman Wu for his remarks, and especially the encouraging news of the performance of the Chinese economy. Thank you for bringing us this good news at the beginning of the new year. And it's always a great excitement to come to New York City, especially to share the joy of the new year with the New Yorkers. Actually, I was here not long ago on the New Year's Eve at Times Square. But today it's a special privilege for me to join this distinguished group and share with you my thought about what we should do together in the new year, and how shall we do it? Actually, we are less than 3 weeks into the year 2016, but the new year is already quite eventful. I think it's a year of critical importance for all of us. For China, the year 2016 marks the start of the 13th five-year plan. It is the last mile we have to travel before realizing the first centenary goal to double the 2010 GDP and per capita income and build a society of moderate prosperity in all respects by the year 2020. And for the United States, America will elect a new president and a new Congress. I think it's a critical choice for the American people to make. And good luck, folks. For the China-US relationship, the good momentum brought about by the successful state visit of President Xi Jinping last September must be strengthened in the new year. The two countries must work together to ensure a smooth transition into the next year and the next few years, and pave the way for its irreversible growth in the years and decades to come. And these are the New Year resolutions for China, for the United States, and for China-US relations. Now let's have a closer look at what China has to do. Today, China's per capita GDP is about $7,400 US dollars, it will reach $12,000 by the year 2020, if we can maintain an annual growth rate of about 7% in the next 5 years. In the meantime, China must lift more than 70 million people out of poverty. That means over 10 million every year and more than 1 million every month. Then we can say for sure that China has overcome the so-called middle-income trap. This will indeed be a lofty goal for a country with over 1.3 billion people. It will also be an important contribution to the development, prosperity, and peace of mankind. To do this, China is further deepening its reform in all respects and implementing a development approach that is characterized by five key concepts: innovation, coordination, green growth, openness, and sharing. Innovation means that we will transform the pattern of economic growth for it to be driven by innovation. Coordination means that we will try to promote political, economic, cultural, social, and ecological development at the same time and bring about more balanced development between rural and urban areas and between different regions of the country. Green growth means that we will highlight green and low carbon development and put even greater emphasis on environmental quality. Openness means that we will keep our door open to the outside world and continue to pursue an opening up strategy that brings mutual benefits. Sharing means that we will not only make the pie of development bigger, but also ensure its better distribution so that the benefits are shared by all. And when this is achieved, we will move on towards the second centenary goal, which is to build China into a modern socialist country that is prosperous, strong, democratic, culturally advanced, and harmonious by the centenary of the People's Republic. These two centenary goals are by no means easy tasks. As Dr. Henry Kissinger has observed, what China is doing now is like a third revolution in the contemporary history of the country. Indeed, this is a revolution that will enable an ancient nation to modernize itself. And this is a strategy that will meet the growing aspirations of the Chinese people and serve their best interests. When these goals are realized, the Chinese nation will see its dream come true. But our dream is defined by how we see the world in the 21st century. We believe that the world today is increasingly undergoing profound changes. Peace and development remain its defining feature. At the same time, mankind is faced with unprecedented challenges. The world is increasingly becoming a community of common destiny. No country can insulate itself from the threat of terrorism, the risk of financial contagion, the threat of infectious diseases, or the impact of climate change. No country can deal with these challenges single-handed. These challenges call for more cooperation among nations. They make us partners with each other. Therefore, zero-sum game or winner-takes-all are obsolete mindsets and will only lead to a situation of no winner at all. With this world outlook, China has chosen the path of peaceful development. We are convinced that such a path will best serve China's development needs while bringing benefits to the international community as a whole. We reject the assertion that confrontation between rising and established powers is inevitable. We are confident that the so-called Thucydides trap will and can be avoided if our view of the world and our commitment to community building are shared by others. It is with this in mind that we see the need to build a new model of major country relationship with the United States. This new model is both a long-term goal and an ongoing process. It is both a set of guiding principles and an operational framework. It calls on the two countries to take a constructive and creative approach to deepen mutual trust, expand cooperation, and properly handle differences. It provides us with a clear sense of direction in our daily work, and what we do every day helps it take shape. It will adapt to changing situations and will probably take up new dimensions. Yet the key features are always clear. No conflict or confrontation, mutual respect, and win-win cooperation. China has no intention, nor the capabilities, to challenge the leading role of the United States in the world. We are still a large and diverse developing country with more than 1.3 billion people. Our priorities are domestic. Our biggest ambition is better life for our people. China recognizes U.S. interests in the Asia Pacific. We welcome a constructive and positive role by the United States in the region. As President Xi Jinping pointed out, the Pacific is vast enough for both China and the United States to develop. We do not and will not embrace any version of the Monroe Doctrine. We are opposed to any attempt to draw a dividing line in the region between exclusive and confrontational blocs, whether military or economic ones. The Asia-Pacific should not become an arena of major country or major power rivalry. No country, big or small, can gain anything from it. All of us should work together to make this region of ours a bright spot of peace and stability on the world scene and a stronger engine of growth for the global economy. China and the United States share the responsibility with the rest of the world to maintain and improve the current international order. Together, we should aim for better global governance. And of course, setting international rules is not a matter of either or, that is, either by the United States or by China. Nor should it be a matter between us. It is a task for all members of the international community. China's development has benefited from the current international order. We have also participated in and contributed to it as it evolves. As China grows stronger, we are ready to take up more international responsibilities and make greater contributions. And in this context, the Belt and Road Initiative, the establishment of the Silk Road Fund, and the AIIB, the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, which started its operation just last week, are all designed for this purpose. We hope that the United States will also be our partner in these projects. Naturally, China and the United States do not see eye to eye with each other on everything. Probably there will never be a day when the two countries have no differences at all. But we should not get lost when we are confronted with tough issues. We should not give up when seemingly insurmountable barriers arise. We should not allow ourselves to be confused and misled by suspicion or fear. We should always keep in sight our growing mutual needs and common interests. We should always handle the differences creatively, constructively, and confidently. In fact, this is what the new model of relationship is all about. And ladies and gentlemen, in building up this new model of relationship, we'll continue to count on the support of the business communities of the two countries. China is now the United States' largest trading partner and provides a market worth of $450 billion for American goods and services. At the same time, Chinese investment in the United States is growing rapidly. It has outpaced annual U.S. investment in China. These investment flows deliver benefits to both Chinese and Americans, including more jobs and more competitive consumer markets. They also help cement China-U.S. relations. In this connection, I would like to extend my sincere appreciation to the Chinese and U.S. businesses for your long-standing support and contribution to China-U.S. relations over the years. I hope that the Chinese companies in the United States will continue to act as Chinese ambassadors of goodwill and continue to learn from U.S. counterparts, assume more corporate social responsibilities, and contribute more to the local communities where you are operating. As the Chinese Lunar Year of the Monkey is just around the corner, I would like to wish you all a happy and a prosperous new year. In Chinese culture, monkey is a symbol of smartness. I hope that in the year 2016, both countries and both peoples will make smart and right choices and realize our New Year resolutions together. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ambassador Sui. For those of you who have had the good fortune of attending this event in the past, then you know it's a truly special evening. And I think it really kind of honors people who recognize what Isaac Newton said so long ago, that we build too many walls and not enough bridges. And our first award goes to a man who understands the importance of building that bridge between the United States and China, these two countries. He's the recipient of the Goodwill Ambassador China-U.S. Exchange. Please turn your attention to these screens for a short video.
He's been a leader throughout the country for the past 12 years. Mr. Michael Bloomberg is here.
Mike Bloomberg is a leader, not only in the business world, but in the political arena.
This is someone who created a business in a one-room office and transformed it into a global powerhouse.
I'm proud of the company's success and all the people care. They work hard. As I say, they have great pride in what they do. When they see the name Bloomberg, they think of themselves and not some guy named Mike Bloomberg.
He doesn't have a huge ego. This is not something that he wants to be, you know, known as the king. He thought, I can actually bring a set of skills to tackle tough problems.
He's really making a huge difference, and he's not afraid that it's going to cause a lot of controversy.
He has a big, big heart. He has a big checkbook, but his heart is bigger than his checkbook.
Oh, he's a rock star, all right. Proper rock star.
Well, we started out looking for, in America, it's hard to get a name that you can use that hasn't been used before. And we had problems with the first name we picked, Market Master, and then people were calling it the Bloomberg anyways, and I said, well, that's one name we won't have a problem with getting cleared in terms of other usage, and since other people are going to call it Bloomberg, why don't we? And I vaguely remember nobody thought that was a good idea.
But you did it anyway.
You did it anyways, yeah. I mean,
it worked out.
It seems to have worked out so far. I think that's fair to say.
Ambassador, I'd love to have you come back up and hand out to the award to for our Goodwill Ambassador Award to the man with the big checkbook, but an even bigger heart, Michael Bloomberg. Here from our honoree, Michael Bloomberg.
Shesha, Ambassador Tsui, thank you very much. And to everyone, Happy New Year, or as we say in our household, Gong Xi Fa Choi. Actually, one of the parts, fun parts of being mayor was celebrating the Lunar New Year with New York's Chinese American community every year. It is the largest Chinese community outside of Asia. And unfortunately, 12 years of Lunar New Year's celebrations did not improve my Mandarin skills one bit. I actually still confuse it with my Spanish lessons. So I will stick to English for tonight anyways. Let me begin by thanking the China General Chamber of Commerce for this award and for the work that it does to promote investment and collaboration between businesses in the United States and in China. And let me also thank Ambassador Tsui for all of his work fostering a strong relationship between our two nations. You should know that both the ambassador and I happen to be graduates of the Johns Hopkins University. Me as an undergraduate, the ambassador as a graduate student. And though I'm sure he did get better grades there than I, he cannot claim what I do. I was one of the students who always made the top half of the class possible. Last year, I did invite Ambassador Tsui to attend the White House Correspondents' Dinner in Washington, D.C. as my guest. And I can't tell you what we talked about at the dinner or at the after party till 2:30 in the morning because it is privileged information. But just let me say that it didn't damage U.S.-China relations. Some might even say that all the great progress our nations have made together since then are because of the summit that the ambassador and I had. But what do I know? Maybe it's true. I thought it'd be funnier than that, actually. I also want to thank the excellent Consul General of China in New York, Madam Zhang, for all of her great work. I know she helped orchestrate tonight's performance, although I don't know why she didn't want me to perform. You should know the ambassador and I have become good friends. We've had dinner a number of times together with Diana, and she has a great insight into what's going on in the world. She's always fun to talk to, and her husband is also the Chinese ambassador to the United Nations. So this is a family that really takes the job seriously. If the consular general says yes, my guess is the ambassador jumps, but we'll have to find out whether that's true. Seriously, I'm grateful for this award because of the relationship between China and the United States. It is more important than ever before. We share many shared challenges, as the ambassador talked about, and we share many opportunities. I did have the chance to visit China this past summer and meet with some of the leaders who are shaping its future, including Vice President Zhang and Governor Zhou from the People's Bank of China. That country's economic success has been one of the great success stories of our time, and it really has created better lives for millions of people. Now, it's true there will always be ups and downs. That is true in any economy. But I think China's economy future is better than ever. China is one of the most exciting markets for our company, Bloomberg. We're investing in that country and committed to help it continue to grow. Last year, we held forums and financial centers around the world to help investors understand China's One Belt, One Road initiative. And we're in a unique position to connect Chinese businesses and global investors and global markets and the American business and investors with Chinese markets, and we'll continue looking for new ways to do that. The more we do to encourage collaboration across borders, the stronger both of our countries will be. And when two countries work together, anything is possible. A good example is the global climate agreement that was reached last month at COP21 in Paris, which could not have been possible without cooperation between China and the United States. China wisely recognizes that fighting climate change also fuels economic growth, and it has set ambitious goals for increasing clean energy and peaking carbon emissions by 2030. 20 Chinese cities have joined many other cities around the world in committing to very aggressive targets for reducing carbon. Cities produce something like 70% of the world's carbon emissions, and the work that China is doing with their cities and America is doing with its cities are great examples of how you can really leave a better future for our children. In the years to come, China and the United States will have to continue working closely together in order to fulfill the Paris commitment and its promises for a better life for everyone. And there are many other ways that our countries can collaborate. After meeting in September, President Obama and President Xi suggested creating a hub for trading and clearing Chinese currency in the United States. The more business we do together, the more important that is. We have to pay, we have dollars, they have yuan, and we want to make sure that we can efficiently and at low cost change our currencies to create more business. It's an idea that Bloomberg has supported because we think it would benefit both of our countries, and it would increase investment across borders and help build stronger trade and business partnerships, all of which drives growth and creates jobs. I was glad to be sharing, to be serving as the chair of the working group that is exploring how to make it possible. But once it gets done, it will let both countries be able to do things more efficiently, create jobs in both countries, and give consumers in both countries better products at more affordable prices. I think it's another example of how our two countries can work together towards the common goals that we have. And I thought Ambassador Tsui said it very well. There will always be problems. There will always be disagreements. But we both have the objective to make the people in our two countries have better lives, a better future, and we will do that together. And the year to come, I think, will present many more opportunities to do that. And we look forward to working with all of the people to seize them. 2016, as the ambassador pointed out, is the year of the monkey, a symbol of cleverness, creativity, and ambition. And I think that's a fitting way to describe the partnerships between our two countries today. So thank you all for this award. Congratulations to tonight's other honorees, and all the best for a prosperous new year. And incidentally, thank you for having us in your new hotel. The Chinese now own this hotel. I pointed out to the owner, I've never spent a night in a hotel in New York City, but if I did, I would spend it in this hotel. Thank you.
One more big round of applause for the man who served as mayor of this city for three terms. And I think there's room for one more presidential candidate if you're interested, Mr. Bloomberg. Notice when the ambassador talked about the election, everybody groaned and laughed. I mentioned him and we get a cheer. There you go. Our next speaker was confirmed by the U.S. Senate in 2014 to serve as Undersecretary of Commerce for International Trade at the U.S. Department of Commerce. Stefan Selig heads up the International Trade Administration, so obviously he's heavily involved in the development of the U.S. trade policy on the global stage. So, as you can imagine, he's a very busy man who spends an awful lot of time in Washington, D.C., but we're thankful he found time in his schedule to come here to New York and give some remarks to us tonight. So, Secretary Selig, thanks.
Good evening, everyone. First and foremost, let me start off by thanking the China General Chamber of Commerce for the opportunity and invitation to speak with you again this evening. Between the 2014 annual gala and last year's China Governors Dialogue, this is now my third address before the CGCC, so hopefully I won't embarrass myself too badly tonight, so you might have me back one more time. As head of the International Trade Administration, an agency with the mandate to promote international trade, attract foreign direct investment, and foster a level playing field for U.S. businesses, I can tell you that the CGCC has been a highly valued partner for us. And more to the point, the U.S.-China commercial relationship is more intertwined and more mutually important than at any time before. And it is bright and clear to me that the CGCC has played and will continue to play a critical role in the joint economic success of our two countries. Let me also start out by acknowledging Ambassador Sui, Mr. Xu, and Chairman Wu. And of course, as a longtime New Yorker, my mayor for life, Mayor Bloomberg. So welcome to you all. It is my honor tonight to introduce my friend, Nhi Pin, as he accepts tonight's award for the most influential business person of the year. I should note here that I've gotten to know both Nhi and his chairman very well in my work as undersecretary. Nhi and I worked together during the first reimagined JCCT in Chicago in 2014. That was a critically important session because it was the first time that Secretary Pritzker and I, as well as our Chinese counterparts, looked to transform the character of those talks, specifically by bringing in the insights of business leaders like Nhi into our work streams. And I've also had the pleasure of meeting and working with his chairman a number of times, including most recently during his participation as a panelist during our CEO dialogue in Guangzhou last November. Tonight, Nhi is being honored for the success he has achieved as president of Wangxiang America Corporation. Reportedly, Nhi can comment on this, I presume, Nhi launched Wangxiang America as an auto parts company in 1994, and he did so out of his home. I'm sure it's an elaborate and large home, but today, Nhi's business has $4 billion in revenues, has diversified its holdings to clean energy and real estate in addition to auto parts, has 13,500 American employees on his payroll, and has moved his operations from his home to a 170,000 square foot headquarters in Elgin, Illinois. And it is worth noting that Wangxiang America now comprises 30% of its parents' entire workforce and now generates 17% of its parents' total global profits. So clearly, Nhi's work represents, in the truest sense, a Chinese investment success story and an American business success story. But Wangxiang also represents the letter and spirit of Zhao Chu Chu, or translated as go global. Mr. Mayor, having lived in New York and listening to your Spanish, I can't believe your Mandarin is better than mine, but it was, and that saddens me to no end. As many of you know, Go Global was the initiative implemented in 1999 and formalized under the 10th five-year plan in 2001 by President Jiang Zemin and Premier Zhu Rongji. The motivation behind Glow Global was to motivate and support Chinese companies to expand their footprint through foreign direct investment, to allow them to maximize their distinct competitive advantages, and in so doing, to help grow the Chinese economy. Now, I would argue that the success of Chinese-owned firms, and of course that includes the success of Wangxiang America, that they have experienced over the past 20 years proves that there has been no better partner to achieve this goal than the U.S. And as a former banker of 30 years, who cannot help but advocate for his client if given the opportunity, I can tell you that the distinct economic character of the United States has helped Chinese firms maximize their competitive advantages by mitigating three critical business risks. First, we mitigate market risk. Setting up operations here means utilizing an advanced manufacturing capacity that is second to none, a workforce that is more productive than any other, an innovation ecosystem that carries out a third of global R&D funding, and the broadest and deepest capital markets in the world, and finally, access to the largest consumer market in the world. Second, we mitigate reputational risk. As Chinese companies look to produce quality goods and services, many of those companies have historically faced significant brand challenges. One poll just taken a few years ago found that only 6% of the US consumers were able to name a single Chinese brand. So having a footprint in the United States can go a long way towards enhancing your brand here in the United States and globally. Finally, we mitigate legal risk. With an environment friendly to foreign investment, a legal and regulatory system that protects intellectual property and contractual rights, and a dispute resolution framework anchored by fair and equitable judicial systems, we reduce the legal risks that stand in the way of predictable returns, sound business planning, and preemptive problem solving. And of course, the success of Chinese firms can achieve here in the United States has been and will be critical to China achieving its current and future growth objectives, particularly given the increasingly turbulent economic environment we are experiencing so far in this year of the monkey. Given these comments, you might have thought I was accepting an award on behalf of the United States. But sadly, I will be going home once again tonight empty-handed. At the same time, Chinese firms are acquiring, establishing, and expanding operations in our shores. They have also been true partners for growth here in the United States. Because China stands today as the fastest growing source of FDI in the United States, that has translated to nearly $450 million annually in R&D spending by Chinese-owned firms, and nearly $1.5 billion annually in U.S. goods exports from Chinese-owned firms, and tens of thousands of American jobs. And of course, because of this expanded Chinese FDI, we have deepened our trade relationship to the benefit of American businesses and workers. It is hardly a coincidence that over the past same five-year span, that Chinese FDI grew by a compound annual growth rate of nearly 40%. We also experienced five consecutive years of record exports to China. And today, just under 1 million US jobs are supported by our goods and services exports to China. So I can only assume that this circle of mutual benefit is precisely why Ni, when interviewed by the Chicago Policy Review, said that the main driver of the US-China relationship was, in fact, our business-to-business relationship, an assessment I wholeheartedly agree with. And perhaps the best evidence of Ni's point is how our business-to-business relationship has been more than a driver for our growth. Our relationship has proven to be a driver of our bold agendas. We saw that firsthand when we harnessed that partnership to produce the real benefits and advances in commercial policy over the past two sessions of the JCCT. And we are seeing this particular capability in another profoundly important area. Simply, there is no path to ensuring that our two countries achieve our stated goals of dramatically reducing carbon emissions by 2030 or leading the global effort to combat climate change under the historic Paris Agreement without the work and partnership of our business communities. And of course, this includes Wang Xiang's work within the United States to innovate, develop, and advance clean energy technologies. In all, what Wang Xiang America proves is Zhou Chu Chu is more than a strategy to advance the competitive standing of Chinese firms. It is a strategy to advance the commercial interests of our two great markets. It is a strategy to advance the strategic and diplomatic interests of our two great countries. And ultimately, it is a strategy to advance the global interests of the international community. I think all of this explains precisely why Ni is the perfect choice for tonight's award for the most influential business person of the year. And this also explains why I am so proud of my colleague and friend and all that he is doing. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause to Ni Pin.
Wang Xiang America was founded in 1994. With a desire to expand into the global marketplace. But the goal was not just to become a global supplier, but a local entity as well. So Wang Xiang began acquiring strategic U.S. companies, as well as reviving ailing ones. Today, just 15 years later, Wansheng America has sales approaching $2 billion.
This is Wansheng's American subsidiary, with 27 plants in 13 states and some 6,000 American workers. Pin Nee says every third car made in the U.S. has Wansheng parts.
So whatever we do has to benefit us. We are here to conduct business. We are here to make money.
Today's market is a global market. Not only you have to sell product in the global market, but you have to compete in the global environment. So Wansheng's value is that not only we can be here as of a USA company, but also we come in from China as a Chinese company. When you combine these two, which you benefit from the resources on both sides, then immediately you have very unique position that allow you to compete on a truly global basis. We are working together. And by working together, we got where we are today. And I think by working together, we can definitely move this company to a totally different level.
Secretary Selig, thanks so much. Nee Pen, let's listen to what you have to say.
Thank you. No need for music, for sure. Yeah. And I just recognize, you know, I was young several years ago. Thank you, Undersecretary. I'm very honored here. And I'm sure one day when you leave the government office, there are going to be a lot of awards sitting there waiting for you. And actually, with this in my hand, going back to Chicago, now I feel more confident that at least I can have some influence at home and probably ask for a little better house. So honestly, you know, when Sean started his business in the United States about more than 20 years ago, frankly speaking, at that time, nobody, including myself, could ever thought that our business in the United States could expand that quickly, and the return of our investment in the United States turned out to be better than the return we had in China even. In fact, this is not uncommon. I just recognize today when I look at the white paper, 40% of the Chinese companies surveyed all confirmed that their investment return in the United States is better than the global investment return for their company. So that's quite amazing, frankly speaking. So anyway, so you know, I would say we were just very lucky to be at the right place at the right time, thanks to the globalization. And the synergy between China and the United States has brought us a tremendous opportunity. On the other side, I have to admit, you know, there's still a lot of conflict, a lot of issues. And just as the ambassador say, and as mayor say, as the undersecretary said, I would say, you know, as long as there's two persons on this planet, the conflict is just a reality. From our point of view, the only difference is that we can recognize, you know, the father and the son can still disown each other. The husband and wife can divorce each other. However, we just don't have a luxury from business point of view. We just don't have the luxury to disengage China and the United States, simply because the economy has made us a twin brother joined at the hip. I remember 10 years ago when CGCC was established, we had an event in New York as well. CGCC was established with the mission to promote more Chinese investment in the United States. Oftentimes, I have been asked the question, you know, how we can adapt ourselves into the USA mainstream. My personal opinion is that by hiring tens of thousands of people, paying millions of dollars tax, although IRS still think it's not enough,
investing billions of dollars in the local economy, we are indeed a part of the mainstream. I think the matter is that we just need to come to the podium more often to present ourselves and then go back to the business to act as a good corporate citizen, as well as the ambassador, as Ambassador Sui mentioned today. You know, we just need to do our job. If we do our job, there's nothing can derail the relationship. And can we do it? I think, you know, I was at a launch today, and with all the Chinese company coming here. I'm the president of the Chicago chapter under CGCC. I remember 20 years ago when we organized this kind of organization, it was pretty much just a handful of people in a small room. Now, just in the Middle West, we have more than 100 Chinese companies. They're all investing a lot of dollar in the local economy. So I believe we can do it. Again, you know, I just want to come here to talk about what we believe, and obviously 2016 is going to be sensitive. We think, you know, this is going to be a lot of challenge and controversial, just like we did at the battery deal A123 back in the 2012 when the election year comes. But anyway, we're very confident with all of us working together. And I say this many times, you know, with all of us working together with transparency, with a logical and a rational compromise, just like we do in the business, we can always reach the common ground in which will help all of us. So again, I'm very honored to be here, and I really appreciate this opportunity, and thank you very much, and a happy new year.
Our most influential business person of 2016. One more round of applause for Nipen. Now it's time to honor the most influential real estate person of the year. Once again, I'd like to invite you to take a look at the screen.
I always knew I wanted to be successful. I didn't know what it would be or what it would take to get there or what field it would be in. I was born in Detroit, lived there through elementary school. I got my master's in law in New York. It was the first time I really lived here, and I loved living in the city. I mean, I was very urban in my thoughts. After law school, when I went back to Detroit, I lived in downtown Detroit. When offered to come to New York by one of the partners in the law firm, I said, I think I'd like to go to New York for good. Yeah. It's a city with so much energy and vitality. If you really love the city, you're going to be involved in it and you want to make it a greater city. I started developing affordable housing and saw the impact that had on the city. It wasn't just to see how much money you could make, but it was really to develop something that people wanted to live in and how it impacted them. But the heart of it is really the place you're creating. It's really a question of really great placemaking.
We have a number of distinguished guests here, and it's my privilege to introduce another to you, the Consul General of the PRC to New York, Zhang Qiyue. She has the honor of presenting the next award to Stephen Ross.
Thank you, Consul General Zhang, for the glorious introduction. And as a special thanks to the China Chamber of Commerce. Tonight we celebrate the year of the monkey. But I was born in the year of the dragon, which according to the Chinese zodiac, dragons are innately ready for challenges and willing to take risks. And I think that is really the right year I was born. And I've always thought to myself that if you can do something good and taking some risk in doing it, you're doing something worthwhile. I've visited China many times and as being a developer and marveled at the great cities that were being built in China throughout the whole country, many of them, and wondered and saw the great buildings and the magnitude of those developments. And I always wished that I could really do one of those. And fortunately, we were chosen to build Hudson Yards and assume that risk. And it's something that has been really impactful in my life in trying to really accomplish something that hadn't really been done before. But we really couldn't do these type of things without the help. It really takes, you know, not only the people in this country, but working together in China, seeing what they had done in the past and what they were then doing, and thinking that, you know, can you do something quite as good as that? And we are now embarking on Hudson Yards, which is the largest development ever done in the United States. But we couldn't really accomplish this without the help of the thousands of people that we're working with in China. Not only their financial institutions, but the suppliers, as well as their investors who have made the EB-5 program very, very helpful for us as a developer, as well as for other American developers. And for that, I thank you. I know our success has really been very dependent upon that. So I just like to wish you all a very happy new year. And I would like to encourage you to see the development of Hudson Yards as it's unfolding. And take a ride on the subway, the 7 line. Thank you to Michael Bloomberg for making that happen and the whole development. And I wish you all a happy new year. And look forward to working with the Chamber of Commerce continually. Thank you.
Congratulations again to Stephen Ross. This concludes the first part of our program. We're going to have dinner, and then we'll be back up here. We've got more awards to give out and some great entertainment. So stay put, network a little bit, enjoy your meal. I'll see you in a bit. It's my honor to introduce our next speaker. Before she broke onto the state scene here in the state of New York, she was the highest ranking female elected official in Erie County as a county clerk from 2007 to 2011. In 2011, she went on to be elected to the House of Representatives, and then she was inaugurated as the Lieutenant Governor of the state of New York in January of 2015. Please give a warm welcome to Lieutenant Governor Kathleen Hochul.
Good evening, everyone. Xian Nian Kuai Li, is that close enough for Happy New Year? Does that pass, ladies and gentlemen? I promised my daughter, who studied in Beijing, that I would at least attempt saying Happy New Year. I'm going to say it in a much better way. Happy New Year. I'm so happy to be here on behalf of Governor Andrew Cuomo. And what a special evening this is. I know you have a lot of great business conversations to have. I don't want to interrupt anybody who's talking about bringing more business to the state of New York, so keep those conversations going, okay? That's okay with me. But first of all, Ambassador, I want to thank you for your words of inclusiveness and really a reminder that we are in this together and we face our challenges together, but we are united as a people. We have a shared bond of making sure business does well, our economies are strong, but we also have a lot of personal relationships that have been built over the years through this organization, through the China General Chamber of Commerce, and that's what we treasure, and that's what we celebrate tonight as well. And thank you for your hospitality when I was in Congress and also visiting as Lieutenant Governor to the embassy in Washington. I truly appreciate your kindness. Consul General Zhang, you have been spectacular. You embraced me as a brand new elected official and made sure I got to know all the important business people from China. So thank you so much. Chairman Xu Xian, thank you so much. Also, our new owner of the Waldorf Astoria, Chairman Wu, this place is spectacular. I want to tell you, I love the decorations, by the way. Did anybody notice these beautiful table decorations? So creative. The monkey would be proud. This shows a lot of creativity. I love it. To have our Undersecretary of Commerce here as well, I have a lot of friends in the Department of Commerce. In fact, they asked me if I would head up the Select USA program when I left Congress. I could have done that, but I decided to enter public service as well. So, and also our honorees, Mayor Bloomberg. Your legacy is felt every single day as I walk the streets of New York, feeling safer, more secure, and I want to make sure that you know that even years later, we appreciate your public service to all of us. So thank you. Thank you, Mayor. Mr. Nipin, I understand you've hired so many Americans, but your headquarters is not in New York State, okay? We need to have a little conversation as well. I know you're talking to Kathy Wilde there. You're not going to get out of tonight without when you're surrounded by the two Kathys, okay? So, Kathy, tackle them at the door, okay? and Stephen Ross, thank you so much for believing in New York the way you have and investing us and taking us to even greater heights with your spectacular buildings and investments. And my friend, Congressman Grace Meng, you do us so proud. I love visiting your community with you. I have been to Flushing. I've been to Queens so many times, celebrating the Lunar New Year Parade, which I'm going to do one more time. I hope it's a little warmer than it was last year. And that's coming from someone who grew up in Buffalo. I thought it was cold here last year, so let's see if we can fix that this year. But on behalf of our governor, I want to tell you how much we truly appreciate the people from China, the business people who've made New York your home. You have enriched us. You have added to our wonderful diversity. You've brought your creativity. You've brought a few extra dollars, too, which we really appreciate. But when I walk the streets of Flushing or Chinatown and I see the small businesses of people looking for a chance at the American dream, but bringing the work ethic that they cultivated and developed in their home country, we are a better community and a better state because of that. So I just want to say how grateful I am. Our governor is looking forward to doing a trade mission to China in the very near future. So let's work on that together. That's going to be significant to bring new business back here. I was invited to go, but one of us has to stay. So I'll manage the state while he's gone. I'm sure he'll do great things. So thank you for your friendship. Thank you for inviting me tonight. And I want to wish you all a very happy new year. Thank you.
Thank you again to Lieutenant Governor Hochul. I asked her how to say her name. I didn't want to mess it up, and there I went and messed it up. But her maiden name is Courtney, I found out visiting with her, a good Irish name. My daughter's name is Courtney. Couldn't you have just kept Courtney? But no. But it was a delight, and thank you so much. Great, great comments. Let's give her one more big round of applause. And she's got a very busy schedule, so it's very kind of her to be here with us tonight. Now it's time to honor the Outstanding Member of the Year. Once again, I'd like to have you either look that way or that way because we have a video tribute we'd like to share with you.
I like to think about the evolving investors in the market, and that's what I've followed and really enjoyed.
We're partners, and it is probably one of the best partnerships I think people could have.
I see Darcy evolving in her career, even at this rarefied air.
Darcy Stakeham, one of the most powerful brokers in the most important market.
I want to bring in Darcy Stakeham. She's the vice chairman and head of investment properties.
I think it's close to a record year.
Stakeham sold the single most expensive piece of real estate in U.S. history.
We've had a lot of success with anything from residential to office buildings to redevelopment and development. We've just closed a recent transaction with Kwafu, buying the top of Mima Tower for residential conversion. We've had a great run of working with people like Greenland and Fosun.
This business is so complex and it moves so fast, you just can't do it alone. You really do need a team, and we've got a great one.
And New York City is one of a kind, and we welcome China to it. We look forward to having them emerge into the fabric of the community.
After 28 years of development, CMB is in over 120 cities in mainland China, with branches or representative offices established in Hong Kong, Taipei, New York, London, Singapore, and Luxembourg, among others. Shares have been floated both on the Shanghai Stock Exchange and the Hong Kong Stock Exchange. The bank has also obtained financial licenses for a range of businesses, including commercial banking, financial leasing, fund management, life insurance, and overseas investment banking. Its net capital exceeds 358.3 billion RMB, and total assets are over 4.7 trillion RMB, ranking it among the world's 100 biggest banks. We set a precedent for cash management by Chinese commercial banks, became a leader in building global transaction banking services system. We are here just for you.
The world is theirs. While life varies so much, according to each individual choice. We invest, we create, we at the global level, connecting all kinds of valuable products and services. Solely, with a name to make your life different because of Fosun. To make your life healthy and joyful. And bring big smiles onto your face at all times. These are the choices Fosun has made. The world will be different because of Fosun. Investment makes a better world.
We are International Vitamin Corporation, and at IVC, we're on a mission to become the preferred supplier of vitamins, nutritional supplements, and related health products. Products enriching your health. For more than 55 years, IVC has built a record of producing some of the highest quality dietary supplements in the USA and around the world. It's a history of success that has fueled continued investment and expansion in our business. Today, IVC is one of the fastest growing companies in the nutritional market due to our superior supply chain, high quality, and focus on innovation. The world's nutritional and healthcare needs are growing. So too is the need for innovative solutions that can be delivered with unwavering quality at prices that are attainable to everyone. IVC is the ideal partner to help enrich your business with products that are enriching your health.
项目一直是兵家必争之地，中石油在美发展多年，已经在美设立包括能源贸易、储存、技术研发中心、人才培养机制等多个项目，甚至将美洲地区成品油出口到包括中国在内的亚洲地区。
这个贸易呢，包括这个成品油贸易、原油贸易、天然气电力贸易以及化工品的贸易。那么去年呢，我们的这个业务总量呢，做了这个8900万吨贸易的量。那么在这个量里面，差不多50%，也就是说4500万吨左右，去了亚洲，包括新加坡跟国内市场。 剩下一半呢是在这个区域里边，也就是从这个南美到北美，从北美到南美。
So let me take this occasion now to invite Zhu Hong, the Minister for Commercial Affairs at the Chinese Embassy to the United States, to present the award to Darcy Stakem, the Vice Chairman of CBRE, and Dai Ming, President and CEO of International Vitamin Corporation. I'd like to invite all of you up here on the stage. Tell they're successful because they're all ready to rush off the stage and go do more deals. I want you to stay put. Darcy, if you'll just share a few words, and then Daiming, I'll have you come speak next.
All right. I know this evening is about Chinese and U.S. business relationships, and I'm very honored to represent the CBRE group and to thank Chairman Chen and the CGCC. And I figure the best way to be remembered tonight is to simply say thank you. Good night.
I'm Stephen Dai from International Vitamin Corporation. It's our great pleasure and great honor to receive this award. It's not for me, for our company, and for our entire team in the U.S. across the country, from East Coast to West Coast. Thanks, Mr. Xi, the chairman, and all the executives, the support. IVC commit to continue to invest in the U.S., creating more jobs, benefit U.S. investment, benefit U.S. economy, and also give the returns to our shareholders. Thank you. Happy New Year. Ganbei.
One more big round of applause for those two. Now it's time to invite Zhou Shanjing, the commercial counselor of the Consul General of the PRC in New York, to the stage. And I would also like to have Bo Wei from the Fosun Group and Zhang Tao, Vice President of PetroChina International, to come up as well at this time. And we'll have an awards handoff. We have a translator for you, so why don't you two come up here and share some remarks.
Good evening, everyone. But I need Peter translate for me. 很高兴获得这个奖，但是首先我想非常感谢在座各位对复兴这么多年来发展的支持。
Allow me to first welcome everybody and thank everybody for coming. And I want to thank everybody for the support that they provided our friends to Fosun Group and its development and investments and in going abroad over here to the United States.
另外也特别感谢前面五为我们提供了这么好的一个场地，使我们能够今天聚在这里。
吴总。
吴总。
I'd also like to thank Chairman Wu for his hospitality, for hosting such a beautiful event here at the Waldorf Astoria.
在新的一年里，希望我们能够为中美经济交流和文化交流做更多的工作和贡献。
It is my sincere hope that we together can add more programs and strengthen the cultural relationships and the business relationships between the United States and China and our company.
最后也借此跟各位拜个早年，祝各位及家人新年快乐，身体健康，猴年大吉。当然，这16年能够中一个彩票大奖更好。Thank you.
Allow me to wish everybody a very happy and a healthy new year. Health to everybody, happiness and success in the year of the monkey.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Peter.
Peter is living proof that actually some white guys, middle-aged white guys, can actually speak Mandarin. Big round of applause to him. And Zhang Tao's up here to accept his award as well. Come on up.
Honored to be here. Thank you. Happy New Year. All right.
He didn't want to talk. I said, just say thank you. And he did. It's a good sport. And he waited to get the award, too. So one big more round of applause for him as well. It's time for Sung Shang Yin, the chief representative of the People's Bank of China, representative office for the Americas, and Marisa Ma of China Merchants Bank, New York branch. Let's have them come up to the stage now.
General Manager Ms. Zhou is now on business trip in China, so I'm very honored to accept this award on behalf of him. 2015 is a transformation year for China Merchants Bank, New York branch. We were very active in merger and acquisition business, and we also successfully hosted the China-American M&A forum. So in the new year, we will continue participate in all the CGCC activities, as well as we will also supporting China corporations development in the US. So happy new year for and hope everybody and your family are very happy and successful new year. Thank you.
Now it's time for the Brand of the Year Award again. You know where to look. It's either this way or this way. We have a video to show to you. Fantastic stuff. And to present the award, James Simpson. He's a member of the board of CCCA. He's a senior advisor to the chairman of CCCA, Yuan Ning, and he's the former commissioner of transportation for the state of New Jersey. And he is here on behalf of Yuan Ning, the vice chairman of CGCC, the president of China Construction America, and our winner, Chu Guangsu. And here to show us up once again is our translator.
Have at it.
谢谢。新年好。
Thank you, everyone. Happy New Year.
看到前面这么多巨人得到的奖，那我们就算是一个比较小星星的奖吧。
See so many of my fellow awardees.Very honored to be in front of everybody here.
大家可以看到这张桌子上的作品都是我们那个我们这个品牌，也是我们这些艺术家的作品。
And to see everybody here at the head table, it's actually really an honor to be part of this distinguished group of people.
我感觉非常幸运，因为我知道纽约是一个非常热爱艺术的一个城市。
I'm very honored because New York is certainly very well known for being for being a city of culture and art.
我也觉得非常幸运，因为我觉得为任何一个伟大的一个国家的崛起，和平的崛起，不仅仅有一些像科技啊、金融这样的一个硬实力，同时也需要像文化和艺术这样的软实力。
Considering our countries being such great countries and economies in the world, the economies are not only built on finance, and economics, but they are actually also built on arts and culture.
感谢那个美国的中国商总会给我一个这样的奖。我希望在未来，你们不仅仅能够记住中国的有中国的银行，有中国的石油，有中国的淘宝，也能记住中国的西奇。
中国的
西奇。
So, I'm thankful to CGCC for this honor, and I hope in the future, as CGCC and business in the United States continues to grow, that we not only remember that China has a lot of capital and oil and energy, there are other good things that come out of China, particularly in culture, and arts.
是的，谢谢大家。有机会可以看看我这个桌上的作品。如果大家今天没有机会看的话，可以在故宫汉我们的美术馆可以看到我们的作品。谢谢大家。
You've seen here many of the arts that they have produced on your tables, and if you haven't had time to enjoy all of them, you certainly are welcome to the Guggenheim Museum to see the rest of their artwork.
也谢谢我的翻译，谢谢大家。
Thank you.
Speaking of which, I've forgotten to mention these centerpieces, which are just extraordinary. Feel free at the end of the evening to just take items off the branch. They're gifts to all of you for coming tonight. And I can't agree with them more. Chinese culture is fantastic. Saw the great performance of Rediscover Traditional Chinese Music at the Kennedy Center, and about six seats away from me was Ambassador Sui, and I can't tell who enjoyed it more. I know you really enjoyed it, but I did as well, and I think bringing our cultures together is, again, another extension of that bridge and very important. Now it's time to recognize the Outstanding Media Partner of the Year. Again, I'll ask you to look at the screens.I live in Washington, D.C. I wake up every morning and I read the Washington Post and have my coffee and breakfast, and then I go into work, and in the afternoon I read China Daily, and they do a fantastic job. So I want to invite Yu Ming, the Vice Chairman of CGCC, General Manager of Agricultural Bank of China, New York Branch, and Wang Linyin, the Deputy Bureau Chief of China Daily USA, to the stage now for the award presentation. Come on up.
It's really a great honor to receive this award on behalf of China Daily USA and from the China General Chamber of Commerce USA. So since its launch in 2009, China Daily USA has had one mission, to keep our North American readers current on developments in China and help facilitate constructive dialogue between China and the US. So So the dynamic flow of information we handle daily is created by many of you here and many others in the political, economic, and cultural sectors. Many of you in this room are playing a role in the dynamic and growing political and business interaction between China and the US. And many of you are featured in our newspaper and yearbook, which I'd like to say a few words about this signature publication. The name is Chinese Enterprises in the US. Now in its third edition, this publication profiles major Chinese companies and their executives who have invested deeply in the US. It provides insights on Chinese companies' strategies of investment and reports on trends across a wide range of industries. I'd like to thank you for your continuous support to this book project and for China Daily USA. And I wish you a very happy new year. Thank you.
One big round of applause from Ms. Wong and all the journalists at China Daily. One more reminder, because I forgot to mention it earlier, and I want to just don't forget these wonderful little items. Take one with you as you leave tonight, the centerpieces. You can take it home with you. Okay, so we've seen a lot of winners come up here on stage tonight, but we may even have bigger winners, because it is time now for the raffle. To help me with that, I'd like to have Han Zhou, the Vice Chairman of CGCC and the President of China Telecom America, and Gil Buitrago. He is manager of consolidator sales at Delta Airlines. By way of background, in 2015, the CGCC distributed the second annual business survey to a wide range of members here in the United States. Now, the final survey report was just released this morning. So, in an effort to reward our participants, we allowed them to enter this raffle for two round-trip tickets to China. So Gil will come up here, and he will draw the first two winners, and I will let Han Zhou announce the winners, and the CGCC staff will be here. They'll reach out to the winners afterwards to take care of things, iron things out. So Gil, why don't you come up here? And let's bring it on up, and we'll spin it around a few times. And Han Zhou, come on up. Drum roll, please. Here it comes. Han Zhou will announce the winner, and it is.
I guess this is really a privilege to announce the winner. I guess this is the most relevant part for this gala, yeah. Right?
Let's delay it as much as we can. Yeah. Build up the excitement.
I speak Mandarin. 美国矿产金属有限公司. Anyone here? Okay. If no one's here, we should have another round.
I like that.
Agree? Last time, okay? 美国矿产金属有限公司. No, no one's here. We should have another round. 天物美国公司. No. Skip.
So, we collected business cards. Many of you entered those. That was a check-in. Quite a few of them, as you can see. Now, we're about to pick the raffle winners. And before we do, I want to mention that it's great having Han Zhou here, because China Telecoms America is this fantastic firm. They've been a strong supporter of the CGCC. Look, he's all embarrassed now. They provided two free cell phones with 1 year free service as gifts for the raffle. And in addition, for everyone here who joined today's event, they'll get a free SIM card to use, and you can start using it beginning today. That'll be in your gift bag, and there'll be explanations there. And if you want to join permanently, you'll find instructions on how to do that as well. So, Han Zhou, you will do the honors here, and Gil will have you announce it. Fairness.
You're in English, right?
Yes.
On the other side. So the winner is Jackson Doxer?
Jacob Doxer.
Jacob Doxer. Too much soju, sorry. Jacob Doxer?
There's already another one.
Oh, now we'll do another one. Oh.
Okay, now we'll go back to his rules, which we'll just keep picking until we find some winners. That makes sense, doesn't it? That's fair. Wait a minute. We are accepting the award on behalf of Jacob.
Who's got the award? You got the award?
No, I don't.
We'll take care of you, I promise. Let's move on to number two. A little bit of confusion here, but we'll get this straightened out.
Second one.
Here comes number two. Drum roll again. Boom, 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 boom.
Okay, the winner is Joanna Sung?
Jung?
Joanna?
Yes!
China Enterprise Council.
Come on up, congratulations. We'll shake your hands. The staff will take care of you shortly.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Congratulations.
I was kidding, like,
he's
gonna pick up me. So.
You should specially introduce her. She's from Los Angeles. She represents our Chamber of Los Angeles.
I told you this guy was in charge. There she is. She's from LA. Let's give her a big round of applause. She came the longest distance. She deserves to win. Okay. So that concludes our 2016 gala. I can't thank you enough for coming out tonight. It was obviously a cold, blustery evening. We hope that it's been a warm evening for you, that you've made a lot of great connections, and we hope that you have safe travels tonight, whether you're heading back out to New York or back to New York or back to Washington, D.C., or as far away as Los Angeles. Thanks again, and hope to see you again next year.